Hi, I'm Alex, and today I'm going to be reviewing Fantastic Four. Okay, so a lot of people are saying, like, this is the worst superhero movie ever. And that it's horrible, like, they put zero effort into it. It's not good. I will agree to that. I don't think it's as bad as everyone is saying it is. It did have some good things. I liked the origins. I liked how it shows Reed as a kid, how he kind of had smart things in his brain going on for years, and he had this idea, and for years he had been wanting to make it a reality. And like in the Ultimate Comics, he finally gets that chance. I'm fine with them making Johnny Storm black. In fact, that actor, Michael B. Jordan, I think he was one of the better parts of the movie. He felt like Johnny Storm. He was full of himself. He did stupid things. Like, yeah, that's Johnny Storm. He thinks he's this hotshot. Miles Teller also did a good job. I really felt like he was Reed Richards. The other actors I wasn't too crazy about. The Invisible Woman, she felt a little bit too cold. Like, that's not really what she's like. She was just too mean at times. And Ben, you don't really get to see him that much. And I had been waiting the entire movie for how he's going to be thrown into the mix, like, because he's not a scientist, it doesn't make sense why he would go along with them on their trip. So there's got to be a good reason, and the reason was pretty stupid in the movie, I'll admit that. However, when they use their device to basically teleport to another world, I liked it. It looked cool. Like, they were stupid kids, like, doing something that they shouldn't have done, and they paid the price for it. You see them, how they get their specific powers. There's, like, this huge accident that happens, and then when they're first realizing the powers that they have, like when they first initially see each other, you could see them all horrified. I actually liked that scene. I thought that really worked well for the film. And then when they're captured by the government and the government's trying to weaponize them, like, yeah, that if that happened in real life, that's probably what they would do. And then Miles Teller as Mr. Fantastic, he's in the lab, he's freaking out, like, he's trying to escape through the vents, like, yeah, okay, I believe that. And then that's kind of where the movie dropped off for me. Like, it had a few bad things, but mostly good. From there, it just got super slow. There was a time skip. They never explained what Mr. Fantastic was doing. God, Dr. Doom was just terrible. Like, I kind of liked him in the first half. It was a different take, but I can kind of see it. Jeez, his design looked bad, his motivations were terrible, his powers made no sense. I mean, I like the idea that the reason why he looks the way he does, I like the idea, they just made him look terrible. Like, there were so many other designs they could have done, and they picked a terrible one. And throughout the movie, I realized Ben and Sue never meet. They talk, like, maybe for a second at the beginning of the film, but up until the climax, never have any interactions. It got really slow, the pacing was terrible, the movie was just not good. However, I don't think it was as bad as, say, Catwoman, or Elektra, or Ghost Rider Spirit of Vengeance, even Batman and Robin. This movie, I think, was better than those. I'm not saying this is good. In fact, this is a bad movie. I don't think you should go see it in theaters. Maybe if you're interested, wait for it on Netflix or rent it for like $2 on Redbox or something. But it's not that bad. I just feel like it needs a little bit of defense. Like, hey, it's bad, but we've definitely had way worse. I mean, the director, yeah, he's had some fault. He's definitely guilty for some of this movie, and the producers are definitely guilty as well, but it's getting way too much hate. It's a bad movie, doesn't deserve to be treated this badly. If you like this review, be sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.